So Sailor 2025 is the CNO's vision of the 21st century sailor. It's comprised of three main pillars. There's modernizing the personnel system, enriching the culture, and the column that we're focused on here at NAWCTSD is ready, relevant learning.
Ready, relevant learning itself is, simply put, you're going to deliver the right training at the right time and the right place for that sailor. So you're looking at several things. You're going to look at how does that sailor learn, what do they need to learn, and what's the best way to deliver it to them.
Right now we train them early in their careers, and just like all of us, they forget a lot of that training because they don't use it. They don't have a need to use it until perhaps 6, 7, 8 years down the road, and we really need to refresh that training for them.
And so we're taking a holistic look at how that is done, and really in many ways bringing a modern capability to deliver that training in a more time-appropriate sense, and in many cases of a location that's more appropriate than we are currently doing.
By doing it this way, you get a sailor out to sea quicker. They can actually start performing their duties as a sailor and supporting the mission of that ship, while at the same time, they will be getting the training through ready, relevant learning. They're still getting the same training they would have gotten. They're just going to get it at the most appropriate time in their career.
It saves training dollars up front. It also gets the operational unit, their bodies faster. Over the long run, it saves a tremendous amount of money because we teach you faster, shorter amount of downtime, while you're still deployed and not taking readiness burden on your unit when you leave to go back for training in the future.
Personally, I believe you're going to create a more successful sailor, which again contributes to the overall success of the Navy's mission. But when people feel successful, they tend to want to stay where they're at. So I think that this is actually has huge retention benefits.
Every sailor learns just a little bit differently, right? So I might be a visual learner. You might be someone who benefits from reading, seeing a diagram, it depends. And that is also part of the feedback. How do I learn the best? If it's visual, then give me pictures and videos. If you like schematics and reading, then we'll tailor the learning environment to adapt to the way you learn the fastest and most effectively. And so there's all sorts of possibilities here. We just have to start collecting that data, feeding it back, and then the training system learns how to teach the sailor to learn.
Well, there's a process we go through. We don't just arbitrarily choose, hey, an iPad would be the answer for everything. So when you want to look at the training that the sailor is currently getting, you want to look at what exactly is it they need to know. And then when you boil it down, you dissect those pieces into the different available delivery technologies, the methodologies that are best suited for them to learn that training in.
So that could be on a tablet. It could be a virtual environment by themselves or with other sailors and Marines. It could be a schoolhouse at the end of the pier or in the squadron environment. I believe it's going to be a combination of all those things and probably some things we haven't thought of yet.
We've been very fortunate. We have full command support with this program. And when I say that, what I mean is across the board, we have been able to hand select the best of the best at NAWCTSD to be a part of this program. It's not about NAWCTSD being successful at the end of the day. It's about keeping that end in sight, which is that sailor. We're not doing this just so that we're making change for the sake of change. We're doing this to improve the quality of life of the sailor from a training perspective.
Sailors of today, I tell you, they're going to be impressed by the direction we're going in the Navy. We are really trying to harness the best that industry has to offer to ensure that we are keeping pace with the things that they take for granted. They've all grown up with video games, they've all grown up with mobile devices, and there's no reason why we shouldn't take the best of those capabilities and apply them to the way we train ourselves.